Hi, Bill Nye. My name is Emre. I had thought of a time machine that basically ran on all the data based on your brain. So it basically calculated all the information on your brain and all the data in your life. It would create a vortex which you would go back through and you would go back in time. So it's a time machine. Okay. Now, I was thinking that if you went back once, you would have the memory of going back. So that would create another vortex in which you would go through again. And once you got to the dimension which was in the past, the other time machine with your memory would, because you're the person, it would also form another vortex which would go through, and you'd keep going through infinite vortexes until you were lost and come in infinite space and time. Now, my question is, would it be possible to generate enough electricity to be able to create another vortex which would accelerate time and bring you and generate enough power to bring you back that all the way back to your time and keep it stable with the whole time machine and you in it? So could you please answer that?
Well, of course, it's a very straightforward question. What? So one of the old problems, Emre, is that right? Emre, one of the old problems in all science fiction stories that involve time travel is, can you go back in time and change things so that you didn't exist? Can you go back in time and change things so that by the time it's now, you're fabulously wealthy? Can you go back in time and change things so that the world is completely different and better? Or can you go back in time and accidentally screw everything up? These are old questions in science fiction. And I gotta say, so far, no. However, you can't. However, in the last 10 years, some physicists, and the way I remember this, these guys were in Japan, showed that you could build a time machine if you are allowed to travel near the speed of light in this time machine in a big circle. And you could only go back in time to when the machine was built. This is in theoretical physics. However, in order to go faster or as close to the speed of light, you need enormous amounts of energy, and it might stretch you where your head is going, being accelerated more than your feet, and it would kill you, maybe. These are great questions. And I noticed you use the word vortex a lot. A vortex is a whirlpool, like the center of a hurricane is a vortex. And when the water goes down the drain in the bathtub, that's a vortex. And there's a fabulous thing I hope you learn about in a whole discipline called fluid mechanics, the mechanisms by which fluid flows, called vorticity. Vorticity is a fabulous word. So I appreciate you throwing around the word vortex, but I'm not sure it's exactly what you mean when you're talking about time travel. But think about it. Can you go back in time and change things so that you never existed? It's an old question in science fiction, and it's cool. But as far as anybody knows, time only goes one way. And as far as anybody knows, nobody knows why that is. Going back in time is really hard. And it's related to this thing that has to do with heat. Heat always spreads out. Heat never spontaneously concentrates on its own. By spontaneous, I mean on its own without influence. And the example I'll give you, go all over the world, look at everything you're ever going to look at. Look at a glass of water, look at a lake, look at a pond. They never just freeze in the summertime. It never happens. The heat doesn't go down to the bottom of the pond or up into the atmosphere and the pond freezes on its own. Energy always spreads out. And when you ever something spreads out, it's moving over a distance over time. So time and the spreading out of energy are intimately connected, are closely related. And there's something about that that keeps us from building time machines. Carry on.